Now, there is a provision of renunciation, termination, and deprivation of citizenship. Section 8 of the Citizenship Act 1955 provides that a major and capable person can renounce his or her Indian citizenship. On renunciation, his minor child also loses citizenship, but the minor child can resume the Indian citizenship by after attaining the age of majority. Then we have Section 9, Subsection 1 of the Citizenship Act 1955, which provides that an individual Indian citizen loses his Indian citizenship if he or she acquires the citizenship of another country. It has also been held by the Honorable Supreme Court of India in the case of Prasad Dixit versus Rajiv Gandhi, 1986, that the Section 9 is a complete code regarding the termination of Indian citizenship on the acquisition of the citizenship of a foreign country. Now, on renunciation or termination, the concerned person has to surrender his or her Indian passport to the authorities under the Passport Act. If he or she fails to do so, he or she is liable to receive prescribed punishment. Now, deprivation of citizenship means compulsory termination of citizenship in India. Section 10 provides that the central government may terminate a person's citizenship on certain grounds, like the person commits fraud in registration, the person is not loyal towards the Constitution of India, the person is trading or communicating with enemy when India is at war, the person's citizenship is not in favor of public good, etc. So there are so many grounds on which the person's citizenship can be terminated. Increasingly, in the case of Hari Shankar Jain versus Sonia Gandhi, it's a recent judgment in the year of 2001, Supreme Court. The Honorable Supreme Court opined that a petition to challenge one's citizenship can be filed before the High Court or election judge. Now, so far as non-resident Indians' voting rights are concerned, Parliament has approved voting rights to non-resident Indians in elections, with the Lok Sabha adopting the Representation of the People Amendment Bill 2010. However, the non-resident Indian has to be present in the constituency of on the date of polling. The new law would allow an Indian citizen residing abroad to get himself enrolled in voters list even if he or she was not in India for more than 6 months because of employment, education, or otherwise. However, in the present busy world, it seems unreasonable when non-resident Indians have to come back to India from abroad just for casting their votes. Therefore, it is submitted that there is a need to computerize the voting rights of non-resident Indians. Now, the question arises whether a corporation is a citizen or not. In the year 1963, in the case of State Trading Corporation versus Commercial Tax Officer, the Honorable Supreme Court of India held that company or corporation is not a citizen of India and cannot claim fundamental rights. The court said that citizenship is concerned with natural persons only. The court said that citizenship cannot be conferred upon the juristic persons. However, in the year of 1970, The Honorable Supreme Court of India, in the case of Cooper versus Union of India, this case is also known as bank nationalization case, in which it was held that a shareholder of a company should be considered as an Indian citizen and is entitled to the protection given under Article 19 of the Indian Constitution. The fundamental rights of the shareholders as citizens should not be violated by any state action. Another very famous case which came in the year of 1973, it is a Bennett Coleman and Company versus Union of India. The Honorable Supreme Court again said that the state action not only affects the right of newspapers companies but also of the editors, readers and shareholders. These individuals do have freedom of speech and expression, which should be protected against any unreasonable state action. So it was basically a very landmark judgment in case of fundamental freedom of speech and expression. Once freedom of speech and expression should not be violated by any state action, and there is no need and there is no justification to draw out any differentiation between whether that press is a corporation and he is not a citizen or not. The purpose here is that freedom of speech and expression should be protected. In Godhra Electric Company Limited versus State of Gujarat, 1975 judgment, the Honorable Supreme Court of India held that a managing director of a company had right to carry on business through agency of company. The court said that he had right to challenge the constitutional validity of the concerned enactment. Following bank nationalization and Bennett Coleman cases, the Supreme Court in DC and GM versus Union of India 1983 judgment has held that writ petition filed by a company complaining denial of fundamental rights granted Article 19 is maintainable. So in this module we have discussed the concept of citizenship, that how this citizenship of a country can be acquired, and in India especially we discussed the Indian position, that how citizenship in India can be acquired. And how we in this module we have already we have also discussed the status of the non-resident Indians and how they are acquiring the different position than the overseas citizenship. There are many other current issues which have, although has not been discussed in this module, but still they are nowadays very burning topics. For example, the many countries, they are refusing any kind of refuge to the climate refugees or any other political opponents or whistleblowers or any other political activists or the persons who has been persecuted by their home country. So these things are one of the issue. And in this module we discussed the Supreme Court's famous judgments in which they protected the rights of the shareholders, although they are working in some company, while declining this contention that corporation is not a citizen. The Supreme Court of India has protected Indian citizen shareholders' fundamental rights. With this, I conclude this thing. Thanks.